Thank you. comes up in the band tonight.
Bye.
people are sending up requests. Is that what that means?
This one I wrote to a good friend of mine's lyrics. Who's almost a writer. And so I wrote harmonies with this, and then a man by the name of Nick Hornby wrote a book on pop music, which he cited 30 well-written songs, and he noted this one as one of his favorite songs based on the lyrics, which I didn't write. And then I got in touch with him, and he did some lyrics for me on a William Shatner record that I produced.
William Shatner.
So that led to another thing, which is Nick and I are working on a record right now, which we're going to finish. We don't have a name for it yet, but it has 14 songs, and Nick just got a couple nominations for the Oscar. So he wrote a movie called An Education. You should see it. Anyway, all right, but this song has nothing to do with things, but you liked it for someone else's scripts. Thank you. bass, guitar, and a lot of stuff. The orchestra is supposed to be the rock band in this case. And so Paul Buckminster, if you've heard of him, he did loads of famous things in the 70s. John David Bowie, and every time I turn on the radio, he's playing on it. And he arranged this for me.
Take me out of land.
I promise that I'll stop talking about it. One more. This song, I like to explain it because it actually has a sort of interesting story behind it. My kids are, they're twins, and my twins were born on, they're 10 years old now. They were born on different birthdays. Louis was born before midnight. And he's born like about 11:30. And, having twins is, it's not a very predictable process. And, Gracie came out at 3:30, which was a bit late. So she came out on the other days. They have different birthdays, but they also have, for those of you who give a shit, they have different star signs. One was born Cancer, and the next was Leo. So they're born on the cusp of your signs. I'm a Sagittarius.
Thank you. Thank you.
I actually bought a really nice shirt I was going to wear, and a couple of buttons popped off. Not there. But yeah, it was given to me by the TV show. I was thinking I got a lot of free shirts. It's funny, because they have people in the airport now that ask me, did you know that Ben Folds from Singapore? Actually, from North Singapore. This has a three-part harmony. Let me show it to you. set to sort of an acquaintance who had moved. I lived in Nashville at the time, and there weren't any. It was mostly country, you know, kind of singing people, and so we had a small clique of people who thought we were pretty cool for playing three chords. The other people. And this guy came to town, and he said he had worked for all these famous British acts. He was English, had a Colombian accent. Everyone thought he was amazing. And then we started to doubt his story. He started to seem like a con man after a while. And he said, hey, I always stories about Linda McCartney, climbing divers and stuff. He was surrounded by the only girls in town. And it was going well for him, but then he said that in all honesty, he could never marry a woman that had cellulite. Then there was like eight girls on top of him. Anyway, so he wanted, he said, I'm leaving town, I want to live in the party. So he threw a party. But then, I don't know if he was explaining, but he came back a couple days later. He's like, oh, I should do the party. We ended up partying. A couple parties down the road, and I decided I'd give him a tape. It says, Steven's last night in town.
Thank you. Man. Those who die, I don't know. Thank you.